The Chief Bell got caught covering this case up with his personal friend, Trooper Bronson. Listen to this recording. Listen to this. If I didn't have this recorded, he would lie. He would lie and lie and lie and say he never said this, or he never did this, and he did.
The police department.
So I spoke with Trooper Bronson, and he's a personal friend of mine, and we worked last week on the fatal accident with the children, but he knows that that in the future of our discussions and investigations, he is on a pre-scheduled vacation because he has children and school vacation week. So when he gets back to work, we'll plug in and I will have him look at everything that I have.
Yeah, he leaked all the information to Trooper Bronson.
I'll keep you plugged in. I really will.
Yeah, if you...
Yeah, I'll keep you posted. I really will. All of that was... You hear how easy it is for Chief Bell to lie? So, I believed him because they wear a badge and a uniform. I trusted him and I believed him. He's got the state police involved. So I didn't call the state police. All that time, it was all a big lie. So he never followed up, so I followed up with him, and this is what he told me in a Facebook message. This was like January 2020, months later, 3/7/2020. This is what he says. I don't see what you do, I'm not sure, but they must have right now. The state police are limited by the governor. They cannot be out doing interviews to do this. We're going to have to wait until all this stuff is relaxed. The whole shutdown's driving me crazy, but I don't have any say. He's actually speaking for the state police, and that they're implying that they're going to be doing interviews. And then he says that it's driving him crazy. Well, you know what? Maybe he needs a psychological evaluation. Maybe he needs an administrative leave, and then throw in a lie detector test while they're at it. Because if I didn't have that recorded, he would have lied. It turns out months later, I contacted him again, asking for an update and a case number. And he comes back and he says, we never opened a case because we don't have probable cause. That's what he said. Then I find out that Trooper Bronson works traffic and his supervisor did not know anything about him being involved in this case. And he wouldn't be because he works traffic. He would not work in a case like this to begin with. And Chief Bell would know that him and Trooper Bronson, they would have to have, I later learned that, they'd have to have the supervisor's permission. This was all a big charade to hold me off from going to the state police. This is the beginning of the cover-up that they were creating down there at the Clinton Police Department.
So I spoke with Trooper Bronson.
Yeah, I bet you did.
A personal friend of mine.
Yeah. So hey, this you see what this girl's saying up here? She's got evidence. You know.
We worked last.
What do we do?
On the fatal accident with the children, but he knows in the future of our discussions and investigations.
In the future of our discussions and investigations, like how much information does this girl have? Send it all to me and I'm going to leak it all to Trooper Bronson. I'm not kidding you. That's what they did. Here is, this is what the part of the case, there's more evidence. The guy's in front of my house. They drugged me while sleeping. He's got a black satanic mirror that should be considered a deadly weapon. They left me evidence, and I kept saying it. They left me evidence. It's like they know that the Clinton Police Department would cover up for them. You know, and this Trooper Bronson, I gave them the benefit of the doubt. Trooper Bronson on 8/25/2019, during a barn fire on the Bell Squeeze Road in Clinton, Maine, Trooper Bronson is out there shaking Jim Talbert's hand, and they're all their buddies. And there's another gang member that's saying they don't have any worries about the police department because she has it covered, wink, wink. And then it's later discovered that she's part of the gang. So then, prior to that, in April 20th, 21st, Officer DeLuca came out to my house, and I was showing him that my house was shot. There's two bullet holes in the chimney on my garage. They shot my house from out back in the woods. They're trying to terrorize me to shut me up. Officer DeLuca refused to take the report on this. He refused to even turn on his body camera to record this or even allow me to write a witness statement. So this cover-up started right from the beginning with DeLuca, with Officer DeLuca. And Officer DeLuca saw and knows that he's in the back of a truck. He saw the truck tracks that came down from Jim Talbot's property to my driveway and then went back up to Jim Talbot's property. He wouldn't let me write a witness statement. They wouldn't record the evidence. Nothing. They shot my house. So this was already the beginnings of a cover-up. And then Chief Bell walks in and he creates a big charade. I trusted him. I gave him the benefit of the doubt because he has a badge and he wears a uniform. This was a time-sensitive case. He gave them plenty of time to delete, to destroy, to scrub, and to move those children. You know, this case should have been referred to other departments as well, and Chief Bell refuses to refer this case anywhere else. This is a cover-up. This is the beginning of a cover-up with Chief Bell, and then the harassment started, because in February of 2020, Trooper Bronson started harassing and terrorizing me on the Clinton Main Highway. He was getting up on the back of the bumper of my car. I would pull over and let him pass. He was waiting for me down the highway. He got up back up on the bumper of my car. I pulled over and let him pass, and he was waiting for me down the highway again. And then another time, him and Trooper Bronson and DeLuca, Officer DeLuca, had followed me to Fairfield on the highway, and I was bringing my cat to the vet because I was so scared something happened to my cat. They hurt my cat. So I was bringing my cat to the vet to make sure my cat was okay. So the harassment started right away when this happened with this Chief Bell and this Trooper Bronson. I trusted him.
I spoke with Trooper Bronson, and he's a personal friend of mine, and we worked last week on vacation because he is back to work that I have.
I'm going to give him
He knows that, but we were...
Yeah, he knows that, right? Oh, yeah. I bet he does know that. I bet he knows a lot. Because they would not investigate. He's lying down here, implying that they're going to do interviews. I'm just sitting, I was like, this is bizarre. I trusted him and I believed him. And then I found out much later after this, I went in that email, he said he'd never open a case. That is the beginning stages. And then more harassment set in, which I'm going to put in another, in other videos. But this is Chief Bell's mission statement, and I think somebody needs to start asking who his peers are. You know, it says down here that it's a community-oriented law enforcement agency that has a mutual trust and respect with our community and our peers. Okay, it doesn't say anything about serving and protecting the citizens. All the surrounding towns do. All those surrounding police departments talk about serving and protecting the citizens, but not Chief Bell. He wants the respect of his peers. And that word respect is highly used with gangs. And I find that his mission statement is very odd. And obviously very clear from the get-go, they weren't here to protect me as a citizen of Clinton, Maine. He wouldn't even put a patrol in the area. And then... I mean, more harassment even set in. To me, not gathering evidence, to me, is tampering with evidence. They made me feel like I am less of a citizen, that I am nothing. Shut up. Don't say anything. We're going to do whatever we want to you. You know, we don't have to do anything. And that's just, you know, that's the beginning stages of a cover-up. The Chief from Hell.